This is a large pond, 88 acres, but the Hawaiians who were building fish ponds hundreds of years ago built them, you know, many times larger than this. And the whole point was to raise fish and seafood so that the people living on these islands could subsist off of them. So we're talking literally tens of thousands of pounds of fish that supported, you know, a neighborhood, a village, a community in this Ahupua'a. So it's all about the water and the quality of that water.
VAI stands for Wastewater Alternatives and Innovations. And VAI's mission is to restore healthy watersheds and reduce sewage pollution by converting cesspools throughout the Hawaiian Islands. So most of North Shore, the neighborhoods are right along the coast. Almost everyone is likely on a cesspool. And it's really just a hole in the ground where all the wastewater from the household just goes into a hole. And they have an open bottom. So all of the wastewater just kind of percolates right into the ground.
All of the waste that goes into a cesspool essentially leaches into the surrounding environment.
You need to get a septic tank upgrade. And especially since you guys are close to the water, it would be great if we can get you guys in a system that has like a nitrogen reducing capacity.
You know, with 88,000 across the state leaching, discharging 53 million gallons a day of untreated sewage, that goes directly into our groundwater and can contaminate drinking water and then coastal ecosystems. The native Hawaiians that were here, they knew that from ridge to reef, that everything is connected hydrologically. And so this is basic kind of indigenous knowledge that the Hawaiians had that we're really just now starting to really realize, and that this is not only a massive problem in Hawaii, but across the country.
Hi, I'm Christina. Hawaii with VAI, Alaska, Alabama, folks in Long Island, New York, and the Navajo Nation.
There's this whole subsect of the country, around 25%, who rely on what are called decentralized solutions. So these are remote communities where maybe you don't have electricity, maybe you don't have plumbing, where water comes out of the ground or out of a local watershed and goes right back where it came from.
There's about 30 communities that do not have any type of piped water and sewer in their community. It's going to take innovation to address everything from Alaska down all through the United States. It's not a one-size-fits-all solution.
This week, VAI is hosting a group from the Alaska Native Tribal Health Consortium.
This is the Cinderella incineration toilet. The great thing is, as you can see, it's not connected to a water line or a sewer line.
We need flexibility, creativity, willingness to look at new ideas and new ways of doing things, and really a paradigm shift about how do we think about wastewater.
It is not just the burden of the homeowner or the problem of the homeowner, because it can cost anywhere from $15,000 to $50,000 in Hawaii to replace these systems, and homeowners just don't have that right now.
The grass loves to uptake all that water, and therefore not only are we improving the quality, but also the quantity of the wastewater. But we are able to achieve this for zero electricity in this nature-based system.
You know, you start to realize with problems as big as climate change or wastewater pollution, there's only so much that one person, one group, one state can do.
The more that you can think about this is a ubiquitous problem, the more you can wrap your head around why it's important to solve it.
Around the country, there are similarities in terms of we desperately need funding. We need more federal oversight on these things.
There's a need to educate policymakers and also just educate and kind of open the doors of creativity. So it's exciting to try to move past describing the problem and work towards finding a solution.
I think ultimately the outcome that I'm hoping for most is that communities and people get safe access to sanitation, and that we can close this access gap that we have.